fact?
Our survey says...
I think you'll find, Christopher, that it's correct.
Christopher? Hold on a second, Destiny. I've got a message for you. Let me check the time. It says you are wrong o'clock.
Ha ha ha, very funny. You two, pack it in, will ya? What on earth are you talking about?
Destiny reckons that 15 million people in the UK are in poverty, but I think that she's way out. Yeah, there's lots of poverty around the world, but there can't be that much in the UK. Like, maybe 5 million tops, if that.
I'm not so sure, Chris. I mean, I don't think Destiny's bang on, but I do think she's closer than you. I'd say about 10 million. Well then, who is correct?
Oh. Destiny, I'm sorry.
Is she right? Sadly, I am. Normally, I get a little bit smug when I get things right, but not this time.
The Social Metrics Commission found that in 2017 to 2018, an estimated 14.3 million people in the UK were in poverty.
And in the aftermath of COVID-19, that figure will undoubtedly have risen. Here are some students from St Peter's in Exeter to help us think about what poverty looks like in society in the 21st century.
Being poor in today's society can be difficult. It's not always their fault, but often people look down on others.
I think that people think that poverty only happens in other places in the world, but poverty often happens in this country too, as there are people who are homeless and have money problems.
Being poor might mean you can't buy a home, don't have a place to stay, or you can't pay for electricity, food, water, or clothes.
Being poor may mean you can't afford to go on school trips, or you might not be able to afford new fashion or technology.
So you can be poor in many ways. It can be for money, not being able to afford essentials such as a house or food or water. But also you can be poor in your relationships with your friends or having weak support networks and stuff like that.
Thanks, guys. Poverty comes in many different forms.
One of the saddest sights in the UK over the past couple of years has been the rise in the use of food banks. Professor Green is a rapper and songwriter, and at the end of 2018, he visited Lewisham Food Bank to find out why more people in the UK were being referred to them.
No one in the UK should go hungry, but for many, simply staying afloat is a daily struggle.
This is Professor Green, or Stephen, as
morning.
We're calling him.
Morning. Hey, Jay. Right. Morning. Nice to meet you all.
We'll find plenty for him today.
Hope you've got a good muscles.
A lot of people are coming because of benefit changes. There's also domestic violence.
No recourse to public funds.
We keep a track of how much it weighs and take it out to people.
This year, food banks in the Trussell Trust network have given out over 1 million emergency food parcels to people in crisis. One third of those went to children.
Well, when you've got kids, you probably close out the window. There's times where they've ate and I haven't, because it's all about them. As long as they're fed and they're looked after, that's what it's all about.
I get it. I mean, you've got Summers and Fulton, there's this to think of that.
Oh, yeah.
14.2 million people here live beneath the poverty line.
People probably have a picture in their head of someone who walks in that door in need.
They might be donating, they might be in need, and I've stopped trying to decide which is which because they look the same.
I came here as a client, actually. I had to use a food bank. Everybody's got a different story, some very tough stories. Each person, they come here because they need something, and sometimes it's a talk. Yeah, it's a food bank, but sometimes people come when they're at their last and ashamed of themselves like I was. But you leave with a different mindset altogether. You leave thinking there's something positive out there in the world.
You're calling me big man. You got the wind out of me.
Stopping hunger is about more than food. And it starts with a little bit of kindness.
That's tough to watch, but it's a reality for many in our country.
In the Western world, we can be removed from some of the things that are going on in this world.
Here's what society would look like if the world's population was only 100 people.
In a world of 100 people, 86 could read and write, but 14 wouldn't be able to.
7 would have a university degree, but a whopping 93 would not.
78 would have a shelter, but 22 would have to do without.
91 would have safe drinking water, but 9 would not.
And whilst 82 would have electricity, 18 wouldn't.
We don't know what you thought of in your discussion, and whilst we might not be able to solve poverty in its entirety, there's still a lot that we can do.
Here are students again from St. Peter's to share their thoughts on how we can play a part in helping people break free from poverty.
I think we can all do our part in tackling poverty. You can just give money to charity, or if you want to go the extra mile and see it happening, see it working, you can volunteer for the charities. You can also do things practically, like if you know someone that's struggling financially, you can help them out with that as well.
I think education is important. Technology is moving fast these days, so people need up-to-date skills to help them achieve great things in life.
You could get people in your school to sponsor a child to help them get better education.
You could do fundraising with the people in your school or class to help charities that support people who are poor or struggling, national or local.
There are more than 250 verses in the Bible telling us how we should use our money.
And over 300 on our responsibility to care for the poor and work for justice.
In the book of Proverbs, the Old Testament says this: the righteous care about justice for the poor, but the wicked have no such concern.
Remember me. Our behaviour really does matter.
What would happen if we gave more to those in need?
What would our world look like if we spoke up for those who are most in need?
What would our world look like if we really looked out for the least, the last, and the lost?
It's time to step up, forget the excuses, gotta get up. I gotta do my part, cause I see the way you're set up. I know you're going through it, but you need to keep your head up. Cause God is always with you when the devil tries to get us. The rich are getting richer, the poor are getting poorer. I'm flicking through the Bible when that's not what Jesus taught us. It's time to make a change, and we can change the order of events. If you're sitting on the fence, cross the border, until then you better know that I keep sending one up. Cause if you're below the breadline, you ain't making the headlines. So how you meant to get by, if people just forget why? We're here, it's to give and not just get before we expire. It's all for God anyway, He's the one we're blessed by. It's people that are suffering, that's something I can't let slide. We have to make the others think, there ain't no time for respite. I'm trying to do it now because I'm sick of saying next time.
Staring at your picture on the wall, you are still here.